Welcome to Section 2 of Chapter 5. In this section, Todd will touch base on your commercial contracts and reimbursement structure as it applies to behavioral health services.
Okay, so we've talked about the payer mix. Now let's talk about specific contracts. Each contract's different. Each payer is different. The way they word the contracts are different. You're going to see some of this in Chapter 6. What you want to be prepared for is how those payers treat behavioral health services. Do they pay fee-for-service? Do they pay based on the CPT codes? Do they pay based on a value-based contract? Those are the kinds of things. And if you don't know, ask the question. When you talk to your representatives at the health plans, just ask them. Be real open. Tell them you don't know. You want to learn more about how they do stuff so that you can work with them as a partner to make sure that patients get the best care at the most appropriate place. Like we talked about in Chapter 2, there are lots of different ways to be paid. There are fee-for-service, of course, and there are alternative payment models. Some might be value-based. It might be where you get PMPM dollars per member per month. There might be a mixture of models. The important thing is really understanding how you're being paid, what your opportunity is, and really what works best for your practice in conjunction and in partnership with those health plans.
Refer back to Chapter 2 of this curriculum for more information on the various contract reimbursement models.
As you know, there are, of course, CPT codes for behavioral health services. So be sure you use the right code. Be sure that you capture all of the documentation that is required for those codes. We have included in this chapter a worksheet for the most common behavioral health CPT codes. One thing to keep in mind, be sure that you have documented consent from your patient. Remember also the additional codes that you can add, so screening codes and documentation, any kind of cessation assistance that you're bringing to the patient. All of those kinds of things are important, and be as comprehensive as possible. A rule of thumb is to, you know, be sure you bill everything you do. Whether you know you're going to be paid for everything or not, go ahead and bill it. You'll learn a lot from the EOBs, the explanation of benefits, when they come back to you.
One additional thing to keep in mind, you must be able to track this information in your practice. Tracking and logging information for these behavioral health services will be key in order to have success moving forward.